Have you ever tried to migrate data from one environment to another? That's possible with the Power Platform CLI. You can use the Power Platform CLI data command group to migrate data from one environment to another. There's also the Power Platform Tool command group, and that helps you to launch the configuration migration tool. Marcel Ferreira is here to tell us all about it. Hi, everyone, and welcome to a new episode of Low Code Revolution. Today, we are going to talk about the tool and data command groups within the Power Platform CLI. And to talk about that, we have someone very special with us, and that's Marcel Ferreira. Hi, Marcel. Welcome.
Hey. Hello, Daniel. Glad to be here. Hello, everyone.
Yeah. Can you please introduce yourself shortly?
Yes, absolutely. So I am Marcel Ferreira. I'm program manager and developer and admin experience team. And what we do is we look after the code first or the professional developer experience. We have tools such as Power Platform CLI and also some other tools for the developer to be more productive. And this is what we will talk about today, right?
Yeah. So you get to work with all the good stuff.
Yes, pretty much. And I work very close to Kartik and also David. They are my my colleagues here. And I believe they have been in the show with you before.
Yeah, exactly. We have had them for two episodes, actually. The first two episodes of this series. So great to have you here. So So we'll talk about the tool and the data command groups. So what can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so as you know, the Power Platform CLI, the intention is really to provide an interface, a natural interface for the code first developer. And the Power Platform world, we have several components. There are many ways for you to build and lots of tools to surround that. And in that intention to make the Power Platform one-stop shop, we introduced the PAC Tool command. And the intention of this command is really to make easier for you to install tools, different tools that we have, to make you more productive. And I believe I can share here my extension to show you what I mean. So I have here, I'm using VS Code, and I'm using Windows. It's important to say that this is one of the only commands that works only on Windows. And the reason for that is because these tools, they are made for Windows, okay? So if I use PAC Tool, here's what I have. First, I have a list. So you will know what is installed in your machine. Like you don't need to remember all the tools that you have installed. You keep track, and I will show you pretty quick here. If I go and do PAC Tool list, it will show the tools that I have installed and also the version that I have installed. So what I can do with this command group, it is I can install a tool if I don't have, I can update a tool if I already have, and I can also uninstall the tool if I want. And just to give a quick summary of the tools that we support today, we support a PRT, which is the plugin registration tool, which is a tool used if you want to extend business logic, that's what you will use. We also support CMT, which is the configuration migration tool, which is to move data from one environment to another environment. We will cover this in more details. And also we support the package deployer, which is a tool which we will cover in another time, right? So in a nutshell, this is what the PAC Tool command does. It will help you to install, remove, and manage the tools about Power Platform.
Yeah, really helpful, because you can also see that whenever there's an update available, you can see that in the PAC Tool list, right?
Absolutely. And also, there are some little tricks to make the user experience better. For example, when you install a tool, it will also add to your start menu. You will have a new Power Platform Tools where you can see all the tools installed.
Okay, great.
So just to show quickly here, you can see I have installed the CMT already. So I will quickly remove that so you can see how it works. So back, CMT, this is how it works. And I can use the parameter clear. This will uninstall the CMT from my machine. Now, if I use PAC to list, I don't have CMT installed anymore. Now, if I want to install, I uninstall because I want to show how easy it is to install. Previously, if you wanted to install this data tool, you would have to download the Nuket package, unzip to a folder, remember where it is, and you have to manage that. It was quite confusing. Now, what you can do, you just call PAC to CMT. And if you don't have the tool, it will install for you. If you already have, it will launch the tool. So it should be coming in a minute, and here it is. So as you can see, it installed the tool, and also it opens the tool. And now I think it is a good time for us to talk a bit more about this specific tool, the configuration migration tool. Again, what it does, it is David in the last episode talked about solutions and how you can import solutions from environment A to environment B. But that is just the solution, it's not the data. Sometimes you want to export the data as well. For example, you have a developer environment, you have all set up data needed to perform a specific business process or something, and you want to move from environment A to environment B. This is what I will do. So I will pretty quickly here open the Make portal, which is make.powerapps.com. Here is where you build your Power Apps. And I have two environments. I have a developer environment, and I have a test environment. And I will show these environments in the tool pretty quick as well. So in the developer environment, I have in the account table, I have some sample data here. It will load in a minute. Yeah, I have some sample data here, right? In my test environment, if I open tables and I open account, I don't have anything. It's pretty much empty. So we will use the CMT tool. So first, we will create a schema. What it does, it is I will tell which table I want to export. So let's go ahead and create a schema. I need to authenticate first. Two-factor authentication. And here we are on the tool. So what I want to do is I want to export from developer to test environment, right? So let's select the developer environment. Now I will select the entity. I'm using a standard entity account. So I will just add this entity. I want to export all the fields. I will save and export. First thing, it will ask me to give a name to this schema. So I will call account schema. And now that I have the schema, it will also ask me, hey, do you want to export the data as well? Yeah, I will say yes. And then it will create a zip file with the data. I will call data.zip. Okay, so yep, I have 10 records has been exported. Now that I have the schema, I will import the data. So I will, again, I will have to log in just to get the context of the environments that I'm using. Once again, let me approve the signing.
You're very safe. Very secure.
Yeah, so now I selected the test environment, which is where I want to import my data, right? And I will select the zip file that I created, data.zip. And I will import the data, and it's only 10 records in a couple of seconds. The records will be there in the environment. It's coming through. And you must be asking, okay, but I have to use the UI to do all this process? Wait. Okay, this is done. So I will open my environments again. Here is my test environment. I will quickly refresh here. And here I have my data. Okay. So this is a simple way for you to move data between environments. But again, as a developer, I want to be able to do that in the command line, right? That's why we have this command here, PAC data. And every time you want to know more about a command, you can put help in the end. It will give you more details on the command. So on the PAC data, what I have is I have the export and import. Okay. Notice that I cannot create the schema here. So I have to use the CM22 to create the schema. But once I have the schema, I can import or export using scripts. I can automate the processes, which is what I love personally. So I will do the same process again, but now I will do for a custom table, right? So let me again call PAC to CMT to launch the tool. And I will create the schema first. And I have to log in again. Okay, I need to approve.
So this is only the one-time installation, right? So this is for getting the schema?
Yes, that's correct. I will create this schema, which is I need to describe which tables I want to export, right? So that's what this schema does. So I will log in again in my developer environment. In this environment, I have a solution, which I call demo solution. And in this solution, I have this entity called product. Okay. This is just for the demo. It's a very simple entity, but the point here is that you can use custom entities as well. You just have to remember the entity must exist in all environments, right? The environment that you want to export and import. This handles just the data, not the solution. So once I selected the entity, I will create the schema file. So this is the product. That's the name of my table. I will save this schema. And when it asks, do you want to export? I will say no, because the intention here, and now it's done. So I can close this, and I can close this too as well. The intention here, it is I will create a schema to describe the tables that I want to import or export, and I will use this file to automate or create scripts to import or export data. Just another point, when you import the data, actually the zip file already has the schema in it. So you only need the schema actually to export the data, right?
Okay.
So let me have a look here. So here's my schema, right? Product schema. And what I will do it is I will use PAC data export. And I will quickly use help here, so you will see what options do I have. And I also, so what I will do it is I will export the data from the developer environment to the test environment. So to do that, I will need the name of my environment or the identification of my environment. So let me do a PAC org list. This will list all my the organizations that I have in my environment. So here's my developer environment and here's the test environment. The format is a bit off because it's quite big here, but you get the point. So now I will build the comment. So let's do PAC data export. First, I need to find a schema file here. So let's use this parameter schema file, or I can use the short version SF. And I want to use the product schema. So here's my schema. I need to give a name to the file using the df, which is the data file. Let's call product.zip. And the environment, I need to select the environment where I want to export from. I will use this ID here. Okay. Let me just copy and paste here.
I think you had two dashes, so there should be one, I believe, for the short one before it fails. I have that all the time. I know the feeling.
Oh, yes. So that's super handy. Thank you, Daniel. I can see you are paying attention, which is great. All right, so I exported the file. So if I list here, I have the new file product.zip, right? And now I want to import. So let's use the same command, PAC data import. And let me do the help here just to show you. These are very similar options, PAC data import. And let's just select the data file, which is product.zip. And also the environment, I will just take the ID of the environment. I want to copy to the test environment, right? And there you go. So this is a simple way for you to automate processes. If you want to have, for example, have a dev environment, every time you deploy some change, you want to automatically load data or set up data. That's a super simple way of doing that, right? And now that it's complete, if I open my environment, the data will be there. And that's what the tool does. And again, I'm using PAC CLI to download the tool and to interact with the tool as well. Right. So this is my test environment. If I open product, my sample data should be here. There you go.
Ah, that's great. I really like that you have multiple options for that. So you can still use the tool if you want to, but you can also do Power Platform CLI if you want to have it inside of pipelines, for instance. So that's a really nice one.
Yeah, that's really the value that I see, because using CMT is a great tool, but you have to manually run. And now you can automate a lot, which saves a lot of time. I don't know you, but I love automation. Makes my life so simple.
Yeah, and I'm a lazy me person, too. So. Same here. So, yeah, thanks a lot for the tour around the data and tool command groups. And it was really, really helpful. I think a lot of people don't know about this, so they will be really happy to see these commands. So thanks a lot for showing us. And with that, we are at the end of our episode. So I would like to thank you, all the watchers. And if you like this episode, please like and subscribe and leave a comment if you want to. And I hope to see you at the next episode.